Morning, guys. Episode 3, Savannah Stay at Home Safari. I'm going to be taking you guys out on safari this morning. I'm Kevin. Thought we'd try something a little bit different this morning. Going to head up to the Sand River and try luck with a bit of fishing. So not often we get to talk about or even show you guys some of the fish that inhabit the water systems and the rivers around the area. So for sure a bit of fun and something different to try luck with a bit of fishing. And we're going to be heading up to the Sand River, probably about a 10-15 minute drive up to the north, and let's hope we get lucky with a few sightings on the way. We're lucky enough to have two perennial rivers that run through our reserve. Obviously the Sand River being one of them, and the other is the Sabi River, which runs further south in our reserve. Both rivers run from west eastwards. They actually join inside Kruger Park, and they continue to flow eastwards and actually end up going all the way through Mozambique and out into the Indian Ocean. So probably about 37 different species that they've recorded in the Sand River, and we're going to be hopefully trying to catch one of them. It's a sharp-toothed catfish, so we'll have a few casts and see how we go, and I'll talk you through a little bit. If we're lucky enough to get one, I'll talk you through a little bit on the sharp-toothed catfish and the role it plays here and some of its feeding habits and so on. So let's crack on and see how we go. So the catfish which we're trying to target at the moment, trying to catch at the moment, is pretty much a bottom feeder. So it cruises around the bottom of the river, around the bottom of the waterways, and pretty much like a hyena, I like to call it, the hyena of the river. And it's pretty much a scavenger. So it cruises around the bottom looking for anything to pick up off the ground, sort of dead fish, crustaceans. But like a hyena, it's also a predatory fish, and it can also hunt live food. So in that sense, it can target live fish, catch sort of live fish, little frogs on top of the water, small lizards, and they grow pretty big. 20-30 pounds, they can get up to sort of 5-6 foot, almost the length of me. So you can imagine a huge big fish cruising along the bottom, a frog or an ailing fish on the top or something. It can also come up and grab that sort of predatory like. So at the moment I'm just throwing like a frog type of lure. I'll just talk about that in a little bit, but such a huge part these catfish play in being like the hyena of the river, sort of cleaning up and looking for anything in distress, you know, a frog or a fish or something that's on top of the water, and of course cleaning up around the bottom. So at the moment I'm just throwing this artificial lure. I don't know if you can see it there. It's made to look kind of like a frog, so it's hollow. It floats, and got the little legs at the back there. So just twitching that along the top and hoping a catfish will see that. The sort of stress that's going on, the splashing on top of the water, will hopefully attract it, and they'll come up and grab that. So let's have a few casts and see if we can get lucky. Like a predator, some of these fish like to hang around cover, hang around structure, and ambush their prey. So not a bad idea to always cast along the sides of the banks where the reeds are hanging over, and you're hoping there's going to be a catfish kind of just lurking in the shadows there, waiting for something like a frog to kind of just plop down in front of it, and then bang, they'll come out and snap at it like that. So I found something pretty cool. What's happened is a hippo's come out of the river behind us here. You can see his tracks on the ground there. Four toes obviously gives it away. There's nothing else that has four toes like that. Hippo's come out of the water, probably a big male, and he's come and marked his territory on this bush here. So heavily, heavily territorial. And this guy's obviously marking his spot, claiming his territory. He's walked up through here. He's got to this bush here and he's basically sprayed it, defecated it all over it. So flapping his tail, some of you might have seen it before, spreading that dung, spreading the scent, advertising his spot, his place. And something we always got to watch out for, especially when you're on foot, having a coffee, or in this case, having a bit of a fish by the river. But pretty cool to see how he has his little track, he has his little path, and probably one of his little prominent marking points here. Right, so not much luck down at the other little spot we were at earlier. So we've just come upstream a little bit, bit of a deeper pan here, and gonna mix it up a little bit. Earlier I told you a little bit about the catfish, the barbel, being a bit of a bottom feeder, primarily a bottom feeder, a bit of a scavenger. So I've opted to try with a bit of bait. This is a little bit of beef sausage that I snuck out of the kitchen. Thanks, Glory. Not the most exciting way of fishing, not my sort of preferred method. I always enjoy sort of using the artificial lures and things, but this way also pretty effective, and a nice option to just cast out and kind of just let it sit on the bottom, and hopefully something will come along and pick it up. Lost them before we had it. So there's your sharp-toothed catfish. Not the biggest catfish I've ever seen, but that's what we're after. So as we were saying, primarily a bottom feeder, and you can see how that body is just designed to cruise around on the bottom. Nice big powerful tail there. Nice big dorsal fin, single dorsal fin on the top there. The common name for this fish in South Africa is a barbel, and these whisker-like protrusions are actually called barbels. So that's what we call them here in South Africa. And these whiskers are obviously used in murky, dark water, cruising around the bottom. Small little eyes, look how small his eyes are there. So doesn't really rely too much on hunting and finding food with his eyes by sight, but using these barbels, using these whisker-like protrusions, cruising along the bottom, trying to feel out food. And like I say, also an ambush predator, will also hunt. Nice big mouth, you can see that's easy gonna fit a nice little frog fish. He does actually have thousands of rows of little teeth across there, almost feels like sandpaper. You can feel I'm kind of rubbing my finger across there. So not sharp, but compared to other catfish, they are sharper. So pretty cool, that's what we came here for. Always good fun to get what we're after. I'm gonna put this guy back, as we say, let him go, let him grow. And in true South African tradition, again, like the hyena, not the prettiest looking fish, but always worth a kiss before we put him back. Oh, nice. Perfect, so bit of luck, bit of patience, just like safari. Never know what you're going to get when you're out fishing, when you're out on safari, but luck and patience always reward you.